And I thank the gentlelady, and I'll now recognize Mr. Gowdy for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Bopp, can you describe the process of a partial birth abortion so people will have a better understanding of why it might have been banned, and they may actually have a better understanding of why Professor Smith would have argued against that ban?
Yes, a partial birth abortion, as defined under federal law, is where a physician partially delivers, usually the trunk and legs of the baby, leaving only the head in the birth canal, and the baby is alive, and then takes an act to kill the baby at that point, usually thrusting scissors into the back of the skull in order to kill the baby, and then completes the delivery. So it's a way of killing the baby when most of the baby is already outside of the womb.
And there were actually people who argued against banning that barbaric practice?
Oh, yes. I mean, many of the people we've been hearing from today were big advocates for a continuation of partial birth abortions. They have no respect for human life if they consider it to be unborn, or they want to label it as a fetus. And literally anything is all right as far as there seem to be concerned.
Well, let's go to that point, because Professor Smith seems to draw a line, artificial as it may be, between the humanity owed to a viable fetus and the lack of humanity owed to what she considers to be a non-viable fetus. Who gets to draw that line of demarcation between viability and non-viability?
Well, that's a complex question. Number one, it is a medical determination on whether or not a child is viable, but it's a difficult one, and there are many gray areas. For instance, the statistics are after 20 weeks, 1 in 4 can survive. And we would consider that to mean, therefore, that anyone born at that point in time ought to be considered viable. But many times you just simply don't know until later. I haven't heard people that work at abortion clinics are able to make that fine and complex medical decision.
No, I think Professor Smith, if I heard her correctly, said that she was not a doctor and it should be up to the doctors to make that determination. Although I did note the irony, it was 9 damn lawyers who came up with that plan, not of one of whom was a doctor. And I also noted the irony of Hank Johnson wondering why there weren't more women on our side of the aisle when they tend to target those who seek office as Republican women. And there wasn't a single woman on the court when Roe versus Wade was decided, but that doesn't seem to trouble him much either. For those watching at home or here, doesn't civil law recognize the viability of even a pre-viable fetus when it comes time for the plaintiff's attorney to get paid?
There are many instances of cases in various states of wrongful death of the unborn, of criminal laws to punish.
Well, we're going to get the criminal law in a second. Let's just stick with civil right now. When it comes time for the trial attorney to get paid, we have a different definition of viability, right?
Well, viability is simply not relevant.
Exactly. You can be 2 weeks pregnant, and you have a cause of action on behalf of that unborn child. And our friends on the other side of the aisle, some of whom were plaintiff's attorneys, have no trouble being paid for the life of that two-week-old.
Right. The idea of separating, using viability as a standard is really antiquated, and most courts have gone away from that to just simply the point that if the child is alive.
Well, but it's hard to go away from viability when Professor Smith said there's not any humanity owed a pre-viable, she won't say baby, pre-viable fetus.
Yeah. That's exactly.
Did I misunderstand her? Is there any degree of humanity owed?
Well,
you've been sitting beside her all morning. Did I miss something? Is there something outside the bounds of decency we really won't allow as long as the fetus is pre-viable?
Well, as I understand her testimony, if the a born alive infant is considered to be not viable, then we have a free fire zone. We can do whatever we want. We can kill the life. at will, harvest their tissues, whatever the case may be. And of course, the concern about the producing intact infants, which the has been demonstrated in the videos, is of course the possibility that these people, that these unborn children, are alive. And there's even, you know, evidence that one of the intact babies born alive had a beating heart, which is a definition of being alive.
Which is why the videos are relevant to our conversation about partial birth abortion. Mr. Chairman, I'm out of time. I just have two really quick questions for Ms. Smith, which she can answer with a yes or no. Ms. Smith, if we were to double the amount of money available to the providers but give it to someone not named Planned Parenthood, would you be okay with that?
I would have to know who it was going to and whether they were qualified.
Anyone not named Planned Parenthood?
Not anyone, no.
Anyone who's qualified to provide services.
If they provide high-quality services to low-income people in the same way that Planned Parenthood does, frankly, yes.
So you're okay with us defunding Planned Parenthood as long as the money goes somewhere where it can do the most amount of good for the same group of people?
Yep.
You're okay with Congress defunding Planned Parenthood?
Not in the current environment where there is no one able to pick
up. And if there were, would you be okay with it?
If there were, yeah, it would be a different world, and yes, then you could fund that organization.
So if we can identify service providers that meet that same quality of care, not named Planned Parenthood, you'll support the Republicans in defunding Planned Parenthood?
I don't know that you and I will agree on who those people are, and I would have to.
Sure. How about we just try? Why don't we do that?
If you're asking me a hypothetical question,
I'll double the money as long as it doesn't go to the folks who donate money to Democrats, Planned Parenthood. We'll double the amount of money available as long as it doesn't go to Planned Parenthood. How's that?
As long as it doesn't go to Planned Parenthood. Planned Parenthood today is the institution that provides the best, highest quality care to women in this country, across this nation, in cities, in low-income areas where these services are unavailable to them.
They're also the target of videos that are barbaric and heinous and subhuman. So as long as we can get that same level of care and do it through an entity not named Planned Parenthood.
As a very small part of their services, and this is why you oppose them. And that is the only reason you oppose them.
You have no idea why. I was voting to defund Planned Parenthood, with all due respect, Professor, before the videos ever showed up.
I wasn't talking about the videos.
Well, I don't think we know each other well enough for you
probably
to assign
not
a motive to what I'm doing.
I think vice versa.
Thank the gentleman. Just to clarify.